Middleton area.
And we'll continue to follow that story. Thank you, Chris. Tonight, a town of Middleton neighborhood is outraged. A violent sex offender is moving in feet from a daycare, and there's nothing they can do about it. NBC 15's Chris Woodard is here now with more.
John, tonight law enforcement got together to hold a community notification meeting. The goal was to give more information about the sex offender moving in. But when those in attendance realized that they couldn't stop it and they didn't like the answers they were getting, frustration boiled over.
Once the oversight that was put into place, I'm sorry, sir.
No, this is part of the presentation.
We're not here for the presentation.
Would you like to go outside and talk with me? Okay, right now.
When it comes to the safety of their children, the passionate arguments become easier to understand. Tonight, more than 100 people packed a small town of Middleton meeting room to learn more about 28-year-old Charles Patterson, a violent sex offender who will soon be their neighbor.
We were hoping it was a public forum, obviously. We have a lot of frustrations we want to vent, and we're not getting that opportunity.
In 2 days, Patterson will move into this Mineral Point Road home, just feet from a local daycare.
We're talking someone who has specifically targeted young children.
In 1995, he was convicted of using force to sexually assault a child. Police say he did know his victims, both male and female, between the ages of 3 and 16. While people here say they don't want anyone capable of those crimes near their children, their daycare, or their schools.
I'm still pretty worried.
Patterson will be under 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week GPS monitoring, and all daycares, schools, etc. will be restricted areas. Officers will meet with him weekly and also make random checks. He won't be allowed to leave the home without a chaperone.
I wouldn't say I'm getting any peace of mind. I think I knew coming into it that this was going to be more informational.
They need to find a better placement for him.
Obviously, still a lot of frustration tonight, and much of it was with the format of this meeting. People wanted to ask their questions and were hoping they'd have a say in whether Patterson could move in. Well, they don't have a say. It's a court-ordered decision. When officials began giving them the how and why of offender programs in general, one person stood up and shouted out that, frankly, she didn't care about any